Hey, I love San Bernardino. Great to be back. Okay, I'd like to get into a little bit about what we're going to do on this show for the next 3 months. We kind of like to get into history, bankruptcy, volunteerism, the term homelessness, medical cannabis, which we'll be getting into with Elmo Green Meds later on today, local politics, public safety, voting, and much more. Now, I'm sitting here with Danny Alcarez, my producer and co-host, and I was wondering, Danny, how did you go about saving our city?
We need to be business owners. We need to create more jobs and invite other people to come to our city. We create little small businesses, mom and pop stores, and that will get the cash flow flowing. That's what I think.
Well, you're a small business owner, and so am I. I'm a fourth generation business owner. I just wrote my first book. I'm an author, and I've got my royalty check. I think we need to start as many businesses as possible to get jobs, good jobs for the local people, so they can spend money around here in town.
That's right, because the money needs to flow. Once the next city goes bankrupt, the other cities go, because it's like a jet stream. All the money flows everywhere.
It's always about money, Danny, huh?
Oh, we gotta live, we gotta survive, baby.
But when it comes down to it, money can sometimes make it harder.
I guess when you're overzealous with money, then that causes problems.
Yeah, that's a good thing. That's one thing that I'm not. To be honest, I'm starting all over, you know, I'm just finishing up graduate school, so not really rich yet. This is my first job on the radio, and I just can't wait to delve into San Bernardino. Hello, I love San Bernardino. It's Robert Porter here again. And how about we go and get into a little bit of San Bernardino's history? Okay, the first people to love San Bernardino were the natives of Javier County. They were created here in California and called our Valley Mountains home for thousands and thousands of years. Then in 1810, a Spanish padre, Francisco Dumet, came from the San Gabriel Mission, and he named and blessed San Bernardino as a valley in 1810. Now, this is a new start for a very, very old San Bernardino. Now, why did the padre come here in the first place? Well, most likely it was because of an invitation from a local converts that were at the San Gabriel Mission. Now, what did San Bernardino have to offer the Spanish guys? Well, they had native converts, water, fertile grazing land, and lots of other things that resources that they could utilize to try to make their mission system work. And that's San Bernardino History Tidbit. And if you'd like more information on our local history, please check out the San Bernardino City website under the heading History. Hello, I love San Bernardino. We're back here again, and I'd like to get back to that State of the City address. On the line right now, we have the mayor of San Bernardino, Terry Davis.
Hi, Robert. How are you?
Hey, Mayor Davis. How are you doing today? It's been a while since I've seen you. Maybe a week or two, huh?
Thank you. I just wanted to call you.
Thank you so much, sir, and I'm glad you gave took the time to call in here. Could I ask you a couple questions, by the way?
You bet. You can.
Could you let us know what the state of the city is?
I will, on Friday.
Okay, all right. Any word on the bankruptcy? Are we close to getting done with that?
We'll talk a little bit about that on Friday also, so come on out and join us at the state of the city.
All right, well, can I get into a personal question?
Well, it depends.
All right, well, I just want to know, what's your wife's name?
My wife's name is Johnita.
Oh, she's a beautiful lady, too.
I've been married for 42 years.
Really, really? And do you have any kids?
We have four children.
And your name?
I don't know if it's been fucking to the but I also have 13 grandchildren.
Wow.
And so one of our sons competed this past weekend, yesterday, in the Phoenix Marathon. So that's where we were over the weekend, supporting him in that effort.
Well, that's great to hear. My good co-host, Danny Alcarez, has a question for you. Could you ask him?
Certainly.
How are you doing, Mr. Mayor?
I'm doing well. How are you doing?
Pretty good. So, we have a next meeting with you.
Yes, we do. November.
So we need to get everybody out there to vote so we can help put the city together again.
Yes, I appreciate you plugging that. We certainly need to give our community a little more engaged with that effort. So thank you for encouraging them and asking the question.
No problem. We all love family again. We need to get it all together. And with your help, we can put this whole thing together. And we have the radio station so we can all talk and maybe we can tiptoe to come on.
Well, I appreciate that. As you know, over the last 3 weeks, we've held the 5 community engagement meetings with 5 of the schools and families all together with the senior city unified school district. They've been a great partner for us to be able to reach out and find out what the community concerns are. And those have been very well attended. So we're going to take that information and incorporate their ideas into our strategic plan.
Well, that's great. I went to all those community road shows, and you did great speeches there, and it was very interesting to see all the different community members throwing their ideas out there and actually seeing politicians there that accept them.
We had a great turnout, not only from the community, but the support from City Hall and the electors. Everyone there showed a great amount of interest in all the things that the community was talking about. And so we were very fortunate to be able to, like I said, partner with the San Diego Unified School District, Bruce Linda Bader, Aldo Ramirez, and then, of course, Dr. Dale Martin. They were very supportive, and we couldn't have pulled it off without them, and we want them to know how much we appreciated their efforts.
Mr. Mayor, what do you think about the city of San Diego being more business friendly so we can get people to come and open up mom-and-pop stores again so we can have all the cash flow? Because I know you're a businessman. What do you think about that?
I share that sentiment that we need to continually work on trying to streamline things so that business people feel welcome when they come to San Bernardino. And we have in place a very expert community development director who's working along those lines. And as you know, with his help, they put together the Third Thursday Court Street Square Food Truck Fest, and that has been very successful. That event will help the those who might feel an interest in wanting to develop something in the downtown see that there is a great deal of unmet demand in the downtown area. And so that's one of the things that we hope will spur some additional interest.
Could we possibly integrate more history into the development of San Bernardino?
You know, Robert, that is an excellent idea. And so that is one of the things that San Diego shares is a long-term tradition is making sure that our history is continually remembered. And so as we move down that road and take on some of those challenges that were put forth at the community engagement meeting, I'm sure that will be something that we'll want to continue to move in making sure that the community doesn't lose the sense of the traditions and history that is so richly imbued in our culture.
Mr. Davis, I have one more question for you from Emma Greenwood.
Hello, Mr. Miller. How are you doing this afternoon?
I'm doing well, Elmo. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. I have a question for you while you got this call in. What would it take for you to personally consider regulating marijuana in the city?
Well, Elmo, as you know, one of the committees, I believe it was the Legislative Review Committee, picked that up. And so I think we'll let them have a first crack at that.
Well, as I recall, they seemed pretty on board with regulations.
Well, I'm not sure that they were necessarily moving down that direction. I know there was certainly a significant amount of interest on the part of those who were wanting to move in that direction. But if you look at some of the other communities and some of the unintended consequences as a result of Colorado and Washington, that's probably something we'd be very, very heavily scrutinized before moving in that direction.
Sounds good there, David. Thank you very much. I'd like to do a hashtag for State of the City address when it happens. So please join Mayor R. Kerry Davis for San Bernardino's 2015 State of the City address, Friday, March 6, 2015, at the San Bernardino International Airport Domestic Terminal, 105 South Leland Norton Way. The reception begins at 5 p.m. and exceeds 5:45, and the program is from 5:45 to 7 p.m.
For more information, please call the mayor's office at 909-384-5133.
It's been a pleasure talking to you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you very much. Yes, thank you, Robert, and once again, congratulations.
You're the best, Mayor. Thank you so much.
Thanks. Bye now.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. So that was the mayor of San Angelo, everybody. We're starting the show off right. I thank him so much for taking the time to call in. And we're going to hit the next song. Thanks, Joe.
What a show. The top dog of the city of San Angelo.
Hello, I love San Angelo. How you guys doing out there today? I'm here with my co-host, Danny Alcaraz, and Elmo Green Meds. And Danny would actually like to say a few things.
Yeah, Robert. How did you get into this politics stuff?
Well, I've always been interested in politics. But to be honest, the main reason why I got involved in San Angelo City politics was because of development of a park. They wanted to develop Wildwood Park with a charter school and some retail buildings. And I just kind of felt like a park belonged to the people. They needed open space. And also, the park belongs to the trees. And if you're cutting down all the trees, you're ruining our air. So I fought for the trees, and it seems like they're not going to develop on that path anymore.
You know, I do your lie.
Stepped up and gave me an opportunity to get more out of the world. I mean, I love San Bernardino's got 6,000 members already, but I mean, with the radio here, we should at least be able to reach a couple billion, right?
I hope. Yeah. Somebody's got to look at talent and recognize it when they see it. And you got to give them a chance when you see talent. Well, anybody, everybody has dreams. So you need to look at all that. We need to fix our city. Get all the views of that. That's what we need to do.
We need more vision and dreams. And if you can make a difference personally, you. If you want to, you just step up. If you have a business already, maybe try to make another job. Try to fit it in there if you can. Or, you know, make volunteer possibilities so people can come out and then you might meet someone who you care about. Quality people are out there in San Bernardino and there's just no opportunity.
There ain't no jobs out there. People don't realize that. And you're in turmoil like this, it could get worse. Right now, everybody's trying to so busy to survive that there's nothing here.
It's like somebody's in a sick. And, you know, even though somebody's in a sick, it still loves me. So I have to still love somebody again, even though she's sick. So what we gotta do is try to make her well. That's gonna involve getting involved. Involved. That means go to these events. You have to go to the state of the city events. You have to go to the city meeting. There's a city meeting twice a month, and you find it on the city's website. And I'm usually at every meeting. If you need any questions, you can go there. You can speak for 3 minutes, and on anything you wish. So go on down there and tell the mayor, tell the council people how you feel, what your ideas are, and you know what? They actually do listen sometimes.
We got to believe in voting again. Everybody's got to believe. If you don't believe, there's not going to be a change. Everybody's got to vote in San Bernardino. Let's make a change.
Now, there was an election in the city last time that was won by a few votes. So, I mean, every vote counts. But you can't just vote. You have to get out there and register. So on I Love San Angelo Facebook group, we always post where to register and the California Register of Voters. And it doesn't take that long. You get on the website, you go there, and you register to vote. And you can even register to have the ballot sent to your house. So we can do this, San Angelo. Our elections are won with a small number of votes.
That's right. Everybody get out there and vote. We can make the change. We can make the city Boston again like it used to be, like Route 66.
The All-American City.
All-American City. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we really need to involve our history, especially that Route 66 stuff. I think there should be Route 66 murals on every building in San Bernardino.
San Bernardino was Route 66. That was history. That was why I thought about the name building.
We can make it that way again. So if you guys have ideas, please step up and do something. Start that business. Start that organization. You know what? Go clean that park by yourself or with people. You know, just make a difference. Do something. You know, bring food to a homeless person that's starving. You know, maybe I should, you know, help their pet. I don't know. Stray dog. Do what you can do to make the city better. Every little bit counts.
Okay. Let's work on the city. Hey, well, we got one city and another part of
it. That was awesome.
Now, Emma, what would you do to save the city?
What would I do to save? Well, I think everyone knows what I would do to save the city.
Anything besides cannabis for the issues?
Well, I think cannabis is going to be a huge part of how everything can be fixed. If we were to not just regulate medical cannabis in San Bernardino and receive that tax money and put those residents to work in high-paying jobs in these dispensaries, not only that, but we could grow it right here in San Bernardino as an export. We could grow enough to supply Las Vegas, which has legal cannabis.
You're talking about getting the whole world high?
No, I'm not talking about getting the whole world high, but if the whole world gets high, why can't we be a part of getting the money from it?
Interesting. So you're talking about making money when we're just losing money on this stuff right now.
Look at the wine industry. San Bernardino has an opportunity to be the next tourist destination. We already have a cannabis tourism right here that brings over 100,000 visitors a year.
What do you mean, cannabis tourism?
The Orange State just recently had high times. Right, what does Denver, Seattle, Las Vegas, Miami, San Bernardino, what do these cities all have in common?
That they're poor. They're broke.
No, they're not all broke.
What are they going on? What's going on?
They're all part of the kind of this trade poor.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Cities. This is the cities. Los Angeles doesn't get hemp palm five times. The green mouth up. They don't go to LA, they come here.
Why do you think they come here?
Because LA didn't want this tourist trade. They gave it to us on a silver platter.
Interesting. So, if in the future, like, do you think we see more of these events, or do you see them breaking up into smaller ones?
No, I see more and more. Right now, we have almost one every month. In May, there's going to be two in the same month, one at the Orange Store and one at the San Manuel Amphitheater.
So, we will open that store later in the year, so I can get an Indian peace pipe and get some stuff and smoke it up or what?
I don't know.
Don't you need a prescription for this stuff?
Well, it's a recommendation, not actually a prescription.
Could you go into that a little bit, please?
Because of the federal legal standing of cannabis, it can't actually be a prescription. It's a recommendation. Where a doctor, you see a doctor, and they think, you know, after an evaluation, they say to you, we recommend cannabis as a possible way to help you with your treatment.
Okay, are you on a caller for one more green meds?
Hello?
Oh, hi. Actually, this is Brother Babcock. I was calling to congratulate you, Robert, on your first show.
Oh, well, thank you very much, Brother Babcock.
This was a good one, particularly you guys put this together in 1 week. I mean, I have been involved in a couple of radio programs. That's pretty amazing.
Well, we love having a deal, Ms. B.
We do indeed. And anyway, I'll see you tomorrow at the council meeting. When people need to come, I was sick for a month, had to watch
Well, let's get people to those meetings. You're right.
Okay. Congratulations,
buddy.
Thank you, Mr. That is pretty cool.
Right on. We're getting things from everywhere, man. I love you, San Bernardino. Thank you so much for giving me the respect I want to be here every Sunday. I want to keep going. We're going to definitely need new sponsors. So if you guys are interested in sponsoring this show, you know how to find me on I Love Sailing Again Facebook group. Now, Johnny, would you like to add anything?
You can hear it, Robert.
We're going to go into the song and we're going to go right into the talent show. I guess this is me going around, so everybody's sick right now. So next week, hopefully, we can put all our talent, all the tours, everybody together. We can have time here in San Bernardino again. And I'd like to let you guys know that next week we'll have Benito Barrios, Councilman Benito Barrios, as our guest. Thank you very much.